Like Gore Vidal, I never wanted to do anything else but go to the movies. Perhaps because Werner Herzog, the brilliant German director, was right when he said that movies can transmit ecstatic truth, a special truth full of deep human meaning. Well, my name is Jim, and these are the Academy Movie Junkies. This is our studio, and we're very proud of it. We like it. And in here, we're making a series of programs for the internet about movies. And I'll ask my on-air colleague, Brian, to explain a bit about the movies.
Thanks, Jim. Well, one of the things we try to do here at Movie Junkies is we take a look at films dealing with drug addiction and alcoholism, you know, films generally dealing with darker or heavier topics, and we try to relate them to different topics in recovery. And what Jim and I do, as well as all the junkies, is we go around campus and we talk to people here, you know, at this treatment facility, Gatehouse Academy, about what their view is on the film or on that specific topic.
Arthur, get in the car.
No.
Bitterman, open the door.
Bitterman, close that door.
Get in the car.
Not you, Bitterman.
Who are you people?
I'm his nanny.
I'm not. I'm Bitterman.
Morning, Arthur.
Hello, Hobson.
Say goodbye to your friends now, Arthur. Make me.
Ow! Hobson!
Get on the horse.
No, it's okay.
Maybe Daddy can help?
Let me help.
But you're not qualified.
Please,
what? That was no trouble.
You're going to marry Susan Johnson.
Hello, Arthur.
What was that?
A French kiss.
Really?
Because the French always surrender. That was decidedly German.
Your mother will see you now.
Arthur, to what do I owe the pleasure?
I don't want to marry Susan.
Fine. You are cut off.
Cut off from the...
The money.
I think I could live without the money.
I am a grown man, and I shall get a job to prove it. Don't let that undermine what I just said.
We should not get married.
It's a business partnership.
We don't have anything in common.
You love horses.
I don't trust them.
Their shoes are permanent. Who makes that kind of a commitment
we
to
get
a
on.
Shoe?
Do you know how to use Excel?
No.
PowerPoint?
No.
Outlook?
Generally positive. You know, I mean, I have down days like anyone, but... Let me look after you for a change. How does this bag of tea work?
Be careful, it's going to be very, very... Oh, God, no!
Hot.
Are you running from yourself, Arthur?
I wish I was, because I'd let me get away. Put this on, please.
Say, wash your winky.
Wash your winky.
Could you do Chewy?
Hobson, we're
going to hang out together.
I've never hung out in my life, and I'm not going to start tonight.
Hobson!
He's weak. He's stronger than you think.
You used to say, Arthur, you can do anything under the sun.
I never spoke like that.
It was a bit like that.
Do you like it?
Yeah, I'm a bad kitty.
Stop it!
My bed is made of magnets.
Get me out of here!
At least something in this room is attracted to you.
Bitterman? Why are you shaving?
Because Robin doesn't have a beard.
I can see your tummy.
Now, Brian, as we were talking earlier, of course, the earlier version with Dudley Moore was wildly successful. I just wanted to say that I remember it well, and I remember laughing uproariously at the movie.
Don't you wish you were Arthur?
Would the more attractive of you please step forward?
It's going to cost you $100.
Let's make it $200, but I will ask you to Simonize my car.
How rich are you?
I wish I had a dime for every dime I have.
Anticipating your condition, and I brought you orange juice, coffee, and aspirins, or do you need to throw up?
Your wife like that?
I'm not married.
Keep smiling. 688-5549.
Usually one must go to a bowling alley to meet a woman of your stature.
I take it this bum will be calling you.
Dad,
He's a millionaire.
You have my permission to marry him.
Are you a hooker? I forgot. I just thought I was doing great with you.
Will you take my hand?
That would leave you with one. I'm going to take my coat.
You don't have a coat.
Well, I'm going to take my tie.
You're a rich one.
How does it feel to have all that money?
It feels great.
A dumb question.
What's so funny now?
I sometimes just think funny things.
What do you do for a living?
I race cars, I play tennis, I fondle women, but I have weekends off and I am my own boss.
Dudley Moore is Arthur.
Don't you wish you were me? I know I do.
Don't you wish you were Arthur?
Of course, there's the other thing that sticks in my mind, that drunks aren't funny, but he was a funny drunk. Why do you think?
I think back then there wasn't as much of an understanding of you know, addiction and stuff of that nature, and like, you know, I think back all the way to films like The Quiet Man, you know what I mean, with John Wayne, where there were multiple very humorous drunks, the village drunk, classic examples, you know what I mean? It was always, you know, stumbling over things, singing in the middle of the night, you know. Maybe, you know, walking down cobblestone road singing Molly Malone or something like that, you know. And I think the drunk was always something very humorous. You saw it in, you know, films geared towards adults and cartoons and all these different things, you know, across the board. And I think, you know, still in that, I can't remember exactly when the original Arthur was made, maybe 79 or
82,
somewhere around that range. I think even back then, you know, this was around the time of the, you know what I mean, the crack cocaine epidemic was about to happen and all this stuff, and that's when, you know, cocaine dropped its party drug ideal and things started getting really serious. From what I see, this is my own perspective, and I think today, you know what I mean, so many people in the world either are addicted or alcoholics or know somebody that's addicted or alcoholics or have been affected, that it's not really that funny anymore. You know what I mean?
I quite agree with you there. I think there's nothing funny about it at all, except I remember laughing at Arthur. Now, the thing, the original Arthur. So I saw Arthur the other day, Saturday. I went to see it, and there was a fair decent crowd. They didn't laugh very much, but it wasn't, I didn't find it very funny at all, particularly. But what was different was that AA was introduced into the movie. Now, there's nothing funny about AA. And so, once you enter, I really did laugh at that, because I thought to myself, here the problem with the filmmakers, here you've got a guy who supposedly has a drinking problem, and how are you going to do anything about dealing with it unless you bring the concept of AA in? Mm-hmm. And so now, these days, you can't really not bring it in. Mm-hmm. But of course, so there's a double problem, I think, with the movie Arthur. It's not really about an alcoholic to start with. Mm-hmm. It's a romantic comedy about an errant playboy.
Yep.
Who, yes, he drinks a little bit. There's hints about all kinds of other parties, stuff, that, and so on. But when he goes to the AA meeting, he says it's all very boring, and of course it is. I mean, the poor crowd that he's seeing here, people are just coming in, you know what it looks like. And but there is a shining moment in the film there where Helen Mirren, who is playing the Gielgud part of the butler, stands up when he walks out and delivers a speech that he should have said, and it was very good. It kind of described his life, but it was, well, as you can expect with Helen Mirren, it was an excellent delivery of a very, very good speech. And then the funniest part of the movie for me was at the end, when he's at AA and it's his getting his 6 month chip, and he's telling some of his funny stories, of course, because of his wild billions of dollars, he could do anything he wanted, his crazy magnetic beds and all this stuff, and everybody's laughing. So it was a fun AA meeting, and it was good. But I don't think it's a movie that we say want to turn over to the rest of our crowd, because I don't think it's a movie about alcoholism. It's a romantic comedy.
I think, you know, personally, I think, you know, I've seen a lot of, you know, what Hollywood seems to be doing right now, over and over and over again, the past 5 to 10 years, remakes. You know what I mean? Nothing but recycled concepts, you know what I'm saying? And I think even this film, when I first heard about it, you know, I heard, you know, Russell Brand's in it. He's kind of a semi-hot item at the moment. I don't know for how long that's going to be. No offense to the man if he sees this, but I don't know for how long that's going to be. But, you know, when I heard about this, I didn't, you know, when I thought about the original Arthur, it's not going to have anywhere near the comedic depth or anything that came from that. You know what I mean? And I think, you know, it's something, you know, on my own personal commentary, it's something that's been very aggravating to me. It's been this recycled right. material that's been going on. And there's not much original coming out right now. And I think, you know, for this film, I don't think it's something that we're going to really utilize in the matter of, you know, trying to teach alcoholics or make, you know, alcoholic or addicted individuals look at, you know, addictions through a film perspective. But, you know, it exists. And I mean, of course, here at Junkies, we do acknowledge things that deal with addiction, and we try to give our commentary.
Right.
So, yeah.
All right. There we go. I don't think anything more to say about it, frankly. And, we're not going to ask people on our campus to make any comments, and consequently, I don't think we are either.